Hello, Value Investors. Thank you for joining me. My name is Michael from Deep Value Returns and Seeking Alpha. Today, I want to talk to you about Bed Bath & Beyond. This is a stock that I've followed for a while. In the interest of disclosure, I am long here and I could sell at any point without notifying you. So, there's a lot here that I like, namely that there is a strong growth on the bottom line. And I think that it's very achievable, the targets that the company has for 2023. The stock is very cheaply valued right now, and I think that there's a lot here that's going to be interesting for you. So, if you've come across Bed Bath & Beyond in the last several months, most likely you've come across it as a meme stock. Now, I don't know how this got caught up. I think it's because it's a highly shorted stock, and I think that there's not a lot of reason for this to be in that meme category, but yet here it is. So here I am. What I find quite compelling about Bed Bath & Beyond is that the investment I'm trying to think about is something like AutoNation. So I don't know if you know AutoNation, but AutoNation, oh sorry, pardon me, AutoZone, AZO is the ticker, has a long history of doing this really, really well. So they have very little growth on the top line. It's approximately 3 to 4, 5%, kind of thereabouts. But they have very consistently repurchased their shares over time. And they've communicated that extremely well to their shareholder base. And the stock has just done terrific ones. I'm showing the screen how it's done here in the last 5 years, significantly beaten the S&P, but even going back much, much further, it's done this so, so well. And I think that there is a potential for Bed Bath & Beyond to do something similar. I don't really know how that plays out. But right now, investors are so doom and gloomy about this stock that I think that there's an opportunity here. So this is my typical playbook where something slightly misunderstood, I believe, in my opinion, by the market, and the stock is very, very cheap. So the company is saying right here on the screen, you can see for low single-digit growths for Q2, Q3, Q4 of this year. So even though the company has difficult comps of last year, there's a booming house market, and Bed Bath & Beyond thinks they can put out some small amount of growth on the top line. Now, the company is saying that we are right now, we're going to be making approximately 35% gross margins, but we have a target by 2023 to reach 38% gross margins. This is going to be driven by some small amount of low single-digit growth rate on the top, on the comps, and some their own brand initiatives that they have underway. They're cutting back on the amount of inventory that they have. They're growing their digital brand, and the brand is growing very strongly on its digital side. So even if the retail, the physical location is not growing that strongly, it's still a place that you can buy online, pick up in store, so it's a fulfillment center. So the company is really that investing very significantly to be modern, to be relevant in 2022 and beyond. So I think that there is a lot more here that investors, if they're just willing to open their mind, they're willing to see. Okay, so at this present moment, the company is guiding for approximately $1.45 of EPS. Now, this puts the stock right now at 21 times sale, or 20 times, 21 times earnings. This is not sales. This is earnings, EPS. So it's when many companies are being priced at a sales multiple, this just seems so, so cheap to me. Now, here's another thing. So they have this target by 2023 to reach approximately 850 to a billion EBITDA. So even if we take the lowest level, 850 of EBITDA, and you think that this time next year, so in 2022, people are going to be thinking, okay, how is 2023 going to be looking? Because the market's always kind of looking forward at least a year. So at that point next year, you think that the company is going to be priced at 9x EBITDA. If they have consistently reported the figures that are compelling, they've consistently reported some top line growth and some strong bottom line operations, I think that the investors are going to be willing to pay much more than 9x EBITDA. So another thing that I think about is that Bed Bath & Beyond is priced at approximately 0.5x their sales. If you look at Williams and Sonoma, that's priced at 1.5 times sales. There are other companies, for example, RH, that is growing even faster. Obviously, that gets a higher multiple, but it's just so cheap because it's a company that's growing, it's profitable, has a strong balance sheet, it's repurchasing its shares. I think that there's a lot here that could be quite interesting, okay? But the whole point of my thesis is that it's really contingent on it growing it growing its top line a little bit. You need that top line. Without that top line, everything falls apart. But with a bit of top line, expanding margins, as I talked about, that they're going to expand their margins up to 38%, you know, that all falls to the bottom line. You're looking at approximately, by 2023, approximately 850 to a billion of EBITDA. For a stock that approximately trades at close to 3 billion market cap, this is really, really cheap. I mean, it's just, I think so, at least. Anyway, so this is the type of stock that I do have in my marketplace. Oh, last one little thing. So I talked about the share repurchases that they're going on. So they think that they're going to hit around about 105 million shares outstanding this year. Probably going into next year, this is going to even dip below that. So they're repurchasing their shares, so the market cap will come down, so it's even cheaper. I think that all this together works out quite nicely. So as always, this type of stock that I do actually have in my marketplace, if this is something that interests you, come over to my marketplace on Deep Value Returns. You're welcome to do a totally free trial to see if it suits you. I think that there's nothing to lose, really. You come in, you see, if you check it out, you know, if you want a place to source ideas, you just kind of pick three or four names from my top five picks and see how that goes. And hopefully you'll stick around. And if you don't, you know, cancel anytime before the 14 days and don't get charged anything at all. Okay, and I'll see you soon.